not going to go to the Russia, that I will insist here in Poland, that I am going to try to do my best. And it seems like they started to play along with the whole thing. But still, I do have very serious thoughts about, you know, obviously this kind of stuff benefits everybody, because whatever Poland gets, whatever Ukraine gets, you know, it helps Russian democracy, it helps Russian people inside of the Russia. This just obviously is a fact. It doesn't only help domestic people here, but it helps in general. However, whenever the Russians get something, Polish or Ukrainian doesn't see anything else than bombs, basically, and terror. This is a big difference between the two, okay? I have to say, however, about this part number one concerning Russia, you know, a game players in this game. There is another game player who I'm not gonna say. And this game player is also more motivated than not to turn things in a different direction. Donald Trump happened to be one of the players too, but that's something completely separate. Donald Trump was really not, Donald Trump was really a cat that had created issues and have hidden himself behind many, many different issues and have insisted and insisted and insisted on my seeing this Polish immigration procedure as inhumane and just go off, go away from here, discouraged, get the proofs and get out of here and this and that and stuff like this. Now, beside Russian, Donald Trump is some other player too. I'm not gonna say who. Poland did not win yesterday. Poland did not win yesterday, but Poland did yet another step that gave chance itself. That hopefully, in the end, I just hope that sanity is going to prevail. I'm going to put it this way. Like I said, unless you're going to kick me out of here, unless you're going to do something, I have no idea what. Like, if it's going to be bad, I'm going to stick around here. I'm going to try to do my best, because I believe in Polish people. I believe in Poland. No matter what, I would like good thing to happen for Poland. But we're going to see what's going to happen, okay? So that's all I want to say in respect to this immigration interview I had yesterday. Maybe really this, maybe you just, next time, please, if you go inside of my belongings, just please spare me of stuff like that, okay? This is not cool at all, right? Can you see this? It's not cool. This is not good to do the stuff like this. If you already do it, just do it, okay? You don't have to leave me the stuff like this next day, okay? It's already enough you go inside of my things. I mean, come on. All right, next thing what I'm going to do is I'm going to play this audio recording, and you're going to see a lot of details. You won't even have to go read the stuff. You can just listen in English, in Polish, whatever. It's a little bit in Polish, a little bit in English, more in English than Polish. This translator was really nice. Great lady, and the guy who was writing the whole thing was just precious person. But yeah, I would prefer for Polish immigration system also to take my passport. I mean, in a way, not really, but in a way, yeah, like I have explained. I mean, it concerns United States of America, and I'm going to accent United Nations again. This is not exactly the proper way, the proper procedure, especially, again, concerning the first procedure, which I have filed, which lasted for 6 months, when I was not even called on a meeting. I was not even called on a to meet with immigration authorities to discuss the whole matter. Okay, so that's all I want to say. I want to thank these people over there at the airport in Łódź. And certainly I'm going to stick my fingers up for Poland. That's all I want to say. The audio recording is coming. Okay.
What you're about to hear is live audio recording of second application submitted for political asylum in Poland, this time in 2019 on February the 21st at 9 o'clock in the morning. It was second attempt to file for political asylum because Poland have simply disregarded, I should say use entire political asylum procedure over 6 months, entire procedure during which they should meet with me and so on and so forth, to simply, well, pretense as I do not exist, as I don't have the right to even apply for one because I'm a citizen of yet another European Union country, and foremost for the torture purposes. I was heavily assaulted by directed energy weapons, left even without a telephone. My belongings, which were repeatedly destroyed, everything was destroyed, came to extreme when two androids were even destroyed, of which one in the end was stolen, and a laptop charger was destroyed twice within a single month, and so on. So I was left without entire electronic equipment. Station on location where I would depend on a library, which more often than open, it was closed. Compelled into walks to commute to another library where I could use public computers as a means of communication, even as much as 4 hours away, 2 hours each way, let's say, walking, because they would restrain you on a budget of 18, 17 euros per month, and that was the budget that you're supposed to use, and for detergents, for the soap, for the coffee, for everything you have basically in your life, in addition to food and a bed where you sleep. Not even yogurts, like milk products, or yogurts, milk would be served, anything like this. That was extremely poor. Extremely, extremely horrible situation. And the only thing I got when I requested for the work permit after this 6 months of waiting period, during which I was twice declined to apply for this political asylum based on European law, which states that European Union member states, citizens from other European Union member states don't have the right to apply within anywhere within European Union, since entire European Union is deemed as a safe destination. Okay, so this, what you're about to hear, this is the original audio recording. It was done on February the 21st, 2019. For me personally, silence, like they would not even meet with me, discuss anything, for entire procedure in 2018 is nothing more than sign into admission of crime itself on behalf of Moscow. The torture procedures and everything else clearly suggest that this is what the case was. Okay, so this is how I see it, and now you're about to hear, get to know partially a little bit my case, what I have at least suggested them on this interview, and note that not interested in anything in related to Donald Trump and so on. Just wanted to make certain things long and so on, but don't want anything in respect to what's probably the biggest individual acting on behalf of Russia, right inside in Washington, D.C., in the White House.
Dzień dobry. Pan, jestem tutaj ze spotkania o 9. Sprawy graniczne. Jestem z Grotniku. No, bardzo dziękuję.
Thank you. trzeba.
Okay.
be back here. Pana status cywilny? No,
separated, divorced. Разведенный.
Your job, double?
Dziennikarz.
Wykształcenie wyższe? High school?
Tak, jak high school, tak.
Wzrost? Profile?
6, 2, 8, 3, 1, 8, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3
Thank you. tak mówię, no ja już bez ultami, no to 18, nie chcę, żeby iść.
Tak, ale to wiesz.
A ona mówi, ja już mam tam ten.
Nie rozmawiam o pan.
To nie, mamy jeszcze inną osobę, tego zrobimy.
Może być czasu, tak.
Nie, mamy jeszcze dzisiaj.
Ale nie na statu, tylko że mam nielegalnie.
Więc rozmawiamy to inne na przykład. Tu może poczekać sobie.
Można powiedzieć tam i przejść na ciastełkach, to tam zaraz też podejdzie i będzie też. dalej.
Okay.